Hey there. Before this video starts, I do want to take a moment to say that if you or someone you love is going through a mental health crisis and you are struggling with depression, anxiety, or something else, I am providing links in the description for suicide hotline, self-harm hotline, and other self-help sites that you can maybe start to feel better. I take this seriously because it is something that I personally have gone through myself, and it's also something that I have seen many of my friends and family go through. So I want to tell you, whoever you are, I care about you. Even if we don't know each other, I care about you. I love you. Please stay strong. And I beg you to look in the description. Probably not the perfect list, but I hope that is something that can help you. So I love you and stay strong. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Since September is Mental Health Awareness Month, I thought that this would be the perfect time to highlight the differences between toxic positivity and actual positivity. As it turns out, a lot of people don't know the difference. So, before you ask, Nikki, what is toxic positivity? Is that even a thing? Yes, it is. I looked it up on Google. Go ask them. Toxic positivity is basically what people use to kind of like dumb down what you're going through or what you're feeling towards an issue instead of actually like being reassuring and stuff. So typical phrases that you'll hear from toxic positivity is, it could be worse. What about such and such people? You have it easy compared to them. Or it's a temporary problem. Don't worry about it. It's not as bad as it seems. Or just think of the positive. Everything is going to be okay. It's just like, well, you know what, Susie? Right now, not everything is okay, and that's fine. This is the wonderful game of life that we are all playing. Not everything is going to be awesome. Not everything is going to be fixed by a smile or that fake little thing that we tell ourselves to get through the day. The whole point of bringing awareness to mental illness is to tell people that they do not have to suffer in silence, that they do not just have to grin and bear it, and that is exactly what toxic positivity does. A lot of times people will use toxic positivity and they will not realize that they are actually making the problem worse. Because what they're actually doing is kind of saying, like, your negativity is bringing me down, so just don't talk about it anymore. And it's like, that is the exact opposite of what you want people with mental illness to do. You do not want them to suffer in silence. We've already suffered in silence enough. We are drowning by our own thoughts, okay? Let us speak. Yes, we understand that the things that we say are sad and negative. However, that is just a piece of what we sometimes have going on in our heads. It's not that we aren't grateful for what we have. And that is another thing that people like to point out, is that like, oh, you should be grateful for the house that you live in. You should be grateful for the food that you eat. You should be grateful for the friends that you have. And it's like, it is not about those things. It's not that we are not ungrateful. We are extremely grateful for what we have, but we are also aware of people not having the same things that we have. We are aware that possibly in a matter of seconds, everything that we have can be taken away. There is a laundry list of things that will get us down and our brains will just dwell on because there's nothing that we can do about it. People who routinely come out and say, this is how I'm feeling, this is what I'm dealing with, they're not seeking attention, they're seeking help. You do not know how hard it is for someone to come out and be like, this is what I'm going through, because you are putting yourself out there for people to judge, and people judge hardcore. It's like, nobody would put themselves out there willingly, because when you do that, you get judged and that makes you feel worse. People usually feel depressed and anxious because we have no sense of safety. We have no sense of hope. And that feeling is so heavy. A lot of people don't understand it. It feels like you are drowning. And like, yeah, that is the most common phrase that I have heard, but it is so accurate. Which is why when someone tells you, they openly come to you, which means that they trust you, and they tell you how they are feeling and what they are going through, and you just tell them to be grateful for something, you have completely dismissed what they were trying to tell you. Which is toxic positivity, because you're telling that person, don't feel that way, be happy, always be happy. And that's even harder when you go on social media, because what you get slapped with? Positivity, right across the face. If you are not positive, then you're gonna be outcasted. So the differences between toxic positivity and positive attitude is toxic positivity uses minimalization and denial of negative situations. It doesn't allow you to process what you're going through and to work through your emotions. The best way to get rid of negative thoughts is to figure out why you're having them in the first place and to work through the emotions that you're feeling. Positive attitude recognizes the negative situation that you're in, and it also allows you to feel your feelings, but it helps you end on a positive note. That's just like, you know what, I'm going through this right now, but in the end, I will be okay. Toxic positivity forces people to stay silent, and it also creates shame and judgment. People who are suffering with mental illness already have the issue of feeling judged. They have the issue of suffering in silence. Making people feel like they need to stay silent because they don't want to bring anyone down is kind of selfish. It's like, I am not saying go to your friends and family and make them your therapist, but I'm also telling family and friends of a person suffering with mental illness to not dismiss them. Like, we are not doing this for the sole purpose of being negative Nancy's and Debbie Downers. Like, we are doing this because we want help. Like, I had a friend who used toxic positivity a lot, and she ended our friendship because I was too negative for her. I was suffering immensely, and because I was not breaking out of the depression that I fell into, I was too negative for her, and she dropped me. And the effects from that were catastrophic. I felt ashamed because I was like, oh my God, I brought my friend down. Like, I'm a horrible person for doing that. I felt judged because I was seen as a negative person. Even though I didn't mean to do it, it was something that I was going through and I needed help. It drove me to just become silent because I didn't want more people to leave me because I couldn't control what was going on in my head. I and many people have tried to just always have a positive outlook. And that just doesn't happen sometimes. And that's okay. Like, life is not always going to be an up. You are going to have ups and downs and flat lines and all that. Life is not two-dimensional. It is not even three-dimensional. It's freaking four-dimensional, okay? We go through a lot in a span of a lifetime, okay? Even just like me being 22, I've gone through a lot. There are people younger than me who have gone through a lot. And telling me that I should only have positive emotions, I'm not going to, because that's not realistic. What is realistic is realizing that you're going to have negative emotions, positive emotions, and even some mixed emotions about some things that happen. So just to like solidify the difference between toxic positivity and positive mentality, or what is it, positive attitude? Positive attitude teaches us to recognize and to work through our situations while ending on a positive note. It allows us to be like, this happened, this is why I feel this way, but in the end, I'm going to turn out okay. There are also a lot of things that you can do to help increase your positive attitude. Just taking care of yourself, okay? It might not cure you, but it will help you feel more like a person. And honestly, from the people that I've talked to, that has helped immensely. Just being able to take a shower and feel clean, being able to clean your room, it makes it a better living environment. And as a result, it does have a positive effect on your brain. Allowing ourselves to feel the negative emotions that we are feeling also allows us to work through it so we don't get stuck. When we are silent, we are stuck. Like, people suffering from mental illness do not need to feel any more shame and guilt, because I can assure you that we feel a lot of it just from admitting that we are depressed or anxious, because there is so much stigma around it. Last thing I would tell someone with a broken arm is to get over it because their leg isn't broken. Like, their leg not being broken does not take away from the fact that their arm is still broken. So I think I'm going to end that video here because it is 80 degrees outside. I am in my truck and there is no wind flow coming in here. I am sorry if I did not touch enough on this topic. I will link other articles that will spot the differences between toxic positivity and actual positive affirmations and attitude, so you or someone you love can like take a look at what you're telling someone who's depressed or anxious and be like, okay, I can change that. Or you as someone who is suffering with mental illness can look at and be like, okay, I do this to myself. This is what I need to do. This video is only to try and help. I am very sorry if it did not, but I'm going to try my best to link resources so that we can be helped and so we don't have to suffer in silence anymore. Until next time, I hope to see you all again very soon, and to please stay safe out there and look after one another. Bye, everyone.
Thank you.